Hi, my name is Christopher Moeller. I wanted to give you an idea of how one of my paintings comes together from start to finish. I hope you enjoy it, and thanks for watching. All of my paintings begin with a preliminary drawing. This is what I sent to my client. This was a private commission. Once she okays the idea, the next step is to get that drawing onto a piece of board. The way I do it is I have a projector, and I project that drawing onto the wall. And then I transfer the drawing to the painting surface. Once that's finished, it's time to paint. In the beginning stages of a painting, I lay in a black and white underpainting, very simple. And that's so that when I start laying color over the top, I'll preserve my drawing. The medium here is all Liquitex acrylics, soft body acrylics. I water them down and I use them on paper plates as my palette. As each paper plate gets used up, I can just switch it for a fresh one. Don't have to do any cleaning. You'll see several times throughout this painting that I'm unhappy with the drawing, and so I remove it and redo the drawing just with paint. Something that acrylics is very good at, it allows you to make changes very quickly and easily, and it's important to take advantage of that benefit. When you see something you don't like, don't just keep it and struggle with it. Just paint it out and reestablish it. One of the characteristics of acrylic paint is that it dries very quickly. You can use a hair dryer to speed that process up and make it dry even more quickly. Here I'm wetting down the board in preparation for a glaze. I want to knock back all of those bright whites and start getting the values where they're going to be at the end. Here I'm switching to a watercolor round brush, it's called. I'm getting into doing some of the detail work. So at this stage of the painting, I've established most of my large value and color relationships, and now I'm just moving from element to element, trying to bring them to a finish that satisfies me. Thank you. Here's another example of how you can make mid-course corrections. I decided I liked the idea of Lucifer looking back at the viewer. In the end, I wasn't happy with the result, but it was good for me to try it. These large-scale corrections can be very frightening when you're in the middle of them. I've come to the point now where I've done it enough that I know I can recover, but it does feel a bit like you're leaping out into space every time you do it. This is a series of stills that I took during that process, so you can sort of see the evolution as the face reemerges. And then there's the final.